Good morning. Welcome on this beautiful Sunday morning. It is Ascension Sunday. It is Sunday in Memorial Day, and it is a day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I am so glad to be able to bring you worship this morning, and I look forward to next week when we can meet together on the lawn of Lewistown United Methodist Church for an outdoor service for Pentecost Sunday. Woohoo! Please join me in the Battle Hymn of the Republic. I want to just let you know ahead of time that the lyrics are not the same ones that we usually use, but they are beautiful, amazing, and fitting for this special day. Amen and amen. Thank you for worshiping with us this morning. Will you please join me in the call to worship for Ascension Day? A new day has begun. Hope wins. A fresh start is granted. Faith wins. Today you have the opportunity to do something new. Hope wins. Christ is entering your life in a new way. Faith wins. Come, let us worship God who is inviting us into life in a new way, a way that transcends death, a way of hope and faith. Love wins. Let us worship Christ who overcame death to give us new life. And will you join me in our opening prayer? Almighty God, as we prepare to worship today, we ask that you will stretch our imaginations to sense the majesty and mystery of your ascension. Help us perceive how Jesus' presence in heaven can give us confidence in our praying and hope for the future through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please join me in enjoying this beautiful anthem, America the Beautiful, sung by the United States Navy Band. That was absolutely amazing. Our first reading this morning comes from the book of 1 Peter, chapter 4, verses 12 through 14, and chapter 5, verses 6 through 11. Beloved, do not be surprised at the fiery ordeal that is taking place among you to test you, as though something strange were happening to you. But rejoice insofar as you are sharing Christ's sufferings, so that you may be glad and shout for joy when His glory is revealed. If you are reviled for the name of Christ, you are blessed because of the Spirit of glory, which is the Spirit of God, is resting upon you. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that He might exalt you in due time. Cast all your anxiety on Him, because He cares for you. Discipline yourselves, keep alert. Like a roaring lion, your adversary the devil prowls around, looking for someone to devour. Resist him, steadfast in your faith, for you know that your brothers and sisters in all the world are undergoing the same kinds of suffering. After you have suffered for a little while, the God of all grace, who has called you to His eternal glory in Christ, will Himself restore, support, strengthen, and establish you. To Him be the power forever and ever. Amen. This is God's word for God's people. And all God's people say, Amen. So now we're going to listen to a song about how awesome our God is. Isn't that the amazing truth? Our gospel reading this morning comes from the book of John, where Jesus is praying for his disciples. After Jesus had spoken these words, he looked up to heaven and said, "Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, so that the Son may glorify you, since you have given him authority over all people to give eternal life to all whom you have given him. And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I glorified you on earth by finishing the work that you gave me to do. So now, Father, glorify me in your own presence before the glory that I had in your presence before the world existed. I have made your name known to those whom you gave me from the world. They were yours, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now they know that everything you have given me is from you, for the words that you gave me, I have given to them. And they have received them and know in truth that I came from you and that they have believed that you sent me. I am asking on their behalf. I am not asking on behalf of the world, but on behalf of those whom you gave me, because they are yours. All mine are yours, and yours are mine, and I have been glorified in them. And now I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world, and I am, and they may be one as we are one." This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Will you pray with me? Blessed Creator, create in me the heart to speak your message. Bless me with the words to say and give us all the ears and hearts to hear from you. Amen. Glory. We hear that word all of the time, and yet it feels like we can't do justice to the word itself. I looked it up on Merriam-Webster.com, and it not only had multiple definitions, five, just for being a noun, but it is also used in multiple parts of grammar. Most commonly, it is a noun, but it's also a verb and an interjection. Definitions include words such as beauty, splendor, spotlight, gratification, resplendence, isn't that an awesome word? Honor, praise, and exaltation. I find it to be no wonder that the word is associated with God, who is all of these things and so very much more. We also use the word glory when we talk about our country. As a matter of fact, we even call our flag Old Glory. It says something about America that we give it so much honor. So it is important that on this day and on this weekend to honor those who have given so much for our freedom, who have fought and died to protect us from tyranny. So let us take a moment to honor those by saying names out loud or to ourselves. Amen. Today we are also celebrating the ascension of Jesus, where he left our earthly realm to sit in heaven with the Almighty Creator. While reminding his disciples that they have a job to do now, and that job is all about making humanity understand the true glory of God. Jesus glorified the Creator by doing the work he was sent to do, and he asked the Creator to glorify him in return by allowing him to be seated at the right hand of the throne. But Jesus takes that request a step further, and he asks that the disciples be blessed to be able to continue to glorify God. Excuse me. It's water. To be able to continue to glorify God, Creator, Son, and Holy Spirit, that we might in this day be privileged to know God. I have a confession. I've been troubled lately by all the talk of reopening. Now, it's not because I don't want things to reopen. I really do. I'm just troubled by the way we are responding to each other as we decide how to safely re-enter the world. Some of those who want everything to reopen immediately are calling those who don't fearmongers, and while some of those who want to stay closed a little longer are accusing others of hatred and selfishness. We don't really seem to be working together on this, and I find that to be dismaying. Where is the compassion? How is that loving our neighbor? We're not glorifying God or honoring God when we dishonor each other. When Jesus left his disciples to enter the kingdom of God, they were afraid and uncertain. They remained hidden in their upper room until Pentecost, when the Holy Spirit came upon them and gave them the ability to speak to the masses on behalf of Jesus. Even when the people thought they were drunk, they still shared that word of God. The disciples were honoring Jesus, glorifying him by carrying on the work that he had begun. That is what Jesus instructed them to do, and knowing that they would indeed carry on, Jesus spoke up for them to the Creator, calling them his own, and through that relationship, they were the Creator's as well. As a people, we belong to the one who created us. But we have known about the Holy Spirit for a long time, and we still hide in our rooms, afraid and uncertain. When we honor God by choosing to give ourselves to Him, we are giving glory. When we honor each other as we are expected, we are giving glory. When we find ways to communicate that do not belittle or demean, we are giving glory. When we wear our masks out in public to protect our brothers and sisters, we are giving glory. When we resist the impulse to hug our friends, we are giving glory. When we stay home or follow social distancing protocols, we are giving glory to God. No one ever said it would be easy. Let me tell you, I hate wearing the masks. I am claustrophobic, and it makes me crazy. After an hour in the store, I feel very anxious and irritable. My mask is wet and I'm very unhappy. But yesterday, while I was shopping in Giant, I noticed all the cashiers wearing masks, and I began to understand that I really have no room to complain. My mask will come off in the car at the end of this shopping trip, and theirs will stay on all day. I was actually ashamed of myself for the whining that I was doing in my head. When I hug my grandchildren goodnight, I'm reminded of the healthcare workers and essential workers who haven't seen their families for months because they are healing the sick and want to keep their families safe, because they are making things livable for us and want to keep their families safe. And so I do them a dishonor when I refuse to wear a mask or I complain about how difficult this quarantine is. And let me tell you, when I do that, I'm dishonoring God, which is something I never really want to do. How many of us are offended when something about our country is disrespected? I remember after 9/11 how we bonded together as a country, and in the words of Toby Keith, we wanted to put a boot up their butts because we do not take being disrespected lying down. I love this country, even with all of its flaws, and I want to honor it. But how many of us speak right up and defend the country, especially when we've been to war for our country or we have family members who have done so? And how many of us then are righteously indignant when it is disrespected? Let me ask you this. How many of us share that righteous indignation when it comes to disrespecting each other? We are, after all, God's creation, beloved by Jesus, and assured by the Holy Spirit. Why are we not speaking right up when somebody that is dishonored? As a matter of fact, quite often, aren't we the ones doing the dishonoring? We need to show God that glory. Another word I wanted to talk about today is hallelujah. It's a great word, isn't it? I mean, it's there's something so uplifting when you say hallelujah, because it is a way of showing our expressing our gratitude. It is a way of letting God know that we're grateful for all that He has done for us and all that He continues to do for us. And so we raise hallelujahs and we raise thank yous. By glorifying God in all that we say and do, that means that we are giving a hallelujah. We are giving thanks. We're thanking God with actions, and that is a prayer that needs not be spoken because it is heard loudly. Let us give glory and let us give hallelujah. As we celebrate this weekend, the heroes of this country, and I know we should, let us also celebrate this world's greatest hero, God, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, with glory and hallelujah. May it be so. Pray with me, please. Creator, Savior, Holy Spirit, we come before you with thanksgiving in our hearts, with love in our hearts. All that we do and all that we say is a reflection of you. And we confess to failing in this area, Lord. Please give us strength and conviction to be outspoken when you are dishonored. May we speak kindness into our relationships. And Lord, help us to love and honor our brothers and sisters as we love and honor you. We come to you this day with the hope that you will be with those who need you. Heal the broken and the sick. We have community members who are ill, some of whom are dying, Lord, and we ask for your comfort to rain down upon them as well as their families. Lord, there are those who are closing businesses never to reopen because of the pandemic. Help us not blame each other, but help us to understand that illness is not a punishment, just a circumstance, and we can work together to make each other's lives better. Lord, we know that there are those who continue to be unseen because they are on the margins of society, and yet they are just as, if not more, affected by this virus. Lord, give them comfort and let them feel your presence. We lift up our leaders on every level, and we ask for wisdom as they lead us back towards living together while taking care of the most vulnerable among us. Lord, we give thanks for all that you give and all that we have. We give thanks for those who sacrifice in big and small ways, for those who remind us how you expect us to be, and for those who keep us safe and provide healing. You are good, Lord. We honor you by praying these words of our Savior. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Before our benediction, let us join together our voices in singing I Will Rise, if you know the words. Bear with me while I find it. It is a Chris Tomlin song, and the lyrics are on the video I sent. Faithful community, as we slowly enter the world and try to find some way to be together, please bring God into the conversation. Allow yourself to be led in ways that give glory and inspire. Hallelujah. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.